हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, माय नेम इज़ डॉक्टर आशुतोष एंड आई वेलकम यू टू वन मोर वीडियो ऑन बायोमैकेनिक्स। इन दिस लेक्चर वी आर गोइंग टू अंडरस्टैंड टू वेरी बेसिक येट वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टॉपिक्स ऑफ बायोमैकेनिक्स विच आर सेंटर ऑफ ग्रेविटी एंड लाइन ऑफ ग्रेविटी। सो विदाउट एनी डिले लेट्स स्टार्ट टूडेज लेक्चर। दीज आर द टॉपिक्स विच आर वी आर गोइंग टू कवर इन टूडेज लेक्चर। First, we will get an introduction about all the topics. Then, in deeply, we will understand about the center of gravity, line of gravity, pace of support, and what are the factors which affect the center of gravity, line of gravity, and base of support. Let's start first with the introduction of all these four things. Starting first with the gravity, we all are very much aware about the term gravity. We are reading this, listening this, and we have learned this gravity from our very basic schooling, that what is a gravity and how it is important for us. So again, let me describe the gravity for you. So gravity, it is a constant downward force which always acts on your body. It is always acting in the downward direction. This is a type of external force. We have already learned in our previous lecture, when we divide the force, we can talk about external force and internal force. What is an external or internal force? So external force is any type of force which is acting outside the body, and gravity is one such force. Now there is a term which is called as center of gravity. It is the point at which all the body's mass is equally balanced. If I have to balance any object, if I want to balance that object with the help of thread or any rope, if I tie the rope at the center of gravity, then I will be able to maintain the symmetrical position on both the side. I will be able to maintain the equilibrium position of that object in all the directions. We'll understand deeply about the center of gravity in our coming slides also. So for now, please remember that center of gravity, it is a point at which all the body's mass is equally balanced. Now, line of gravity. Line of gravity is a vertical line. It is an imaginary vertical line which is passing from the center of gravity. There is a center of gravity. Example, let's take an example that in body, if there is, this is the center of gravity, like you can see within this circle, the center of gravity, the vertical line which is passing through the center of gravity will be called as the line of gravity. This is the line on which the gravity is acting. Base of support, last but not the least, it is the supporting area beneath the body, which is the base on you, what is the base on which you stand. The base is our feet, so it is the area between your feet. The base of support is the supporting area beneath the body, which is the area between your two foot. As you can see in the diagram also, this the person is standing, and as you can see, this green area is depicting the base of support. Now let's understand all these terms one by one. First of all, center of gravity. Always remember that it is an imaginary balance point. If you need to balance an object, the whole weight will be concentrated on this point. So for balancing it, you need to hold that object from that center of gravity. For example, see, this is a mobile phone. If I have to balance this, I have to put my finger somewhere in between so that I can balance it. Look, if I have to balance it, I need to put my finger in between. If I'll shift, this is the center of gravity. This is the point on which my finger is right now located. It is will be the center of gravity because this is the point on which I can balance the object. So remember, the whole weight of the body or the body segment. Center of gravity can be defined for the body also, and can be defined for the body segment also. We already have discussed all these types when we discuss the radius of gyration. So radius of gyration is the distance between the center of mass or center of gravity to the fulcrum. We already talked about this, that we need to consider the center of mass or center of gravity of the body segments also and the whole body also. Remember that center of gravity, it acts vertically downwards through the center of gravity or the body segment. The whole weight of the body or the body segment is acting vertically downward because gravity is always acting in a downward direction through this center of gravity. Now, what we must understand that the center of gravity or the center around which the body may rotate freely in all direction is equals to the center of mass. Sometimes center of gravity is also called as center of mass. But what is the condition in which we can call the center of gravity a center of mass? It is that the center around which the body can rotate freely in all direction. If this is the center in which the body can rotate freely in all the direction, then it will be called as the center of mass. And the summation of all the forces that will act this point will be zero. I hope the center of gravity is clear. And what are the points that we must know about center of gravity? We must know that it is an imaginary point. We must know that it is the force of gravity always acts in a downward direction, and it is also referred to as center of mass when body can rotate freely in one direction, and the summation of all the forces at this point will be equal to zero. Now, location of center of gravity can be different for different persons, as well as it can be different for different positions of the body. In the diagram also, you can see this person is standing, so center of gravity is somewhere over here. Now, what this person is doing? This person has taken his arms upward and has grasped both the hands. Now, as the weight has been shifted upwards, the center of gravity will be shifted. And where will it be shifted? It will be shifted in the direction at which the mass is more. So center of gravity will be shifted in the direction where the mass is more. Now, as you have taken the arm upwards, so center of gravity will slightly move upwards. In the third diagram, you can see the person has lowered the mass. So the more weight is on the downside. So center of gravity has shifted downwards. Over here, the more weight is on the upward side, so center of gravity has shifted upwards. There are these five things on which the location of center of gravity depends upon. First of all is the proportion of the body parts. You must have seen that there are some persons who have longer legs, and then there are some persons who have longer trunks. Every individual is different from the other one. Their proportion of the body parts are different. It is not same for everyone. As you might have noticed that the sprinters like Usain Bolt have longer legs, while swimmers like Michael Phelps have longer trunk, because if you need to swim fast, you need longer forearms and hands, as well as you need longer upper trunk so that your wingspan is increased and you are able to propel forward very easily, because these muscles will help you in propelling forward. In the case of a sprinter, you need to have longer legs because it helps in gaining the more stride length. So if you have a longer leg, your stride length will be increased. So the proportion of body parts is very important. In the individuals who will have the longer legs, in them the center of gravity will be shifted more upwards. So remember, center of gravity will always be shifted in the direction where more mass is located. If I talk about a gymnast, mostly gymnasts are short-heighted and they have center of gravity lower compared to the sprinters because their height is less. So the proportion of body parts is very important in understanding the location of center of gravity. I hope the first point is clear with you, why the proportion of body parts is important in deciding the location of center of gravity. Now, the distribution of fat and muscle mass in body is also important. As you have seen that females tend to have the center of gravity lower as compared to men. The reason for that is that they have wider pelvis and more fat mass, and the muscle mass is located in the thigh and gluteal region, whereas in males it is the more muscle mass is located in the upper part of the body. So where the distribution of fat and muscle mass will be more, the center of gravity will be shifted in that direction. this is also very easy to understand that if the muscle mass or distribution of fat is more in specific region, then center of gravity will be shifted in that direction. Now posture. The posture is very important for a physiotherapist to understand, because you will deal with many patients with abnormal postures and their center of gravity will be somewhat disturbed, and you need to identify what is the fault in the center of gravity and you need to correct that. If my posture is stoop, I have a forward head posture, or if I have a posture with the rounded shoulders, my shoulders are rounded, my head is forward and I am bent forward, which means that more of my body weight has been shifted forward. That will mean that my center of gravity will be shifted anteriorly or forward. If my posture is somewhat like I am extended backwards, I have a sway back, then my center of gravity will be shifted backwards because more of my weight is on the back side. So posture is very important, and you should be able to identify what is the fault in the posture and how the faulty posture is affecting the location of center of gravity. Now, structural deformities. There are some structural deformities that can occur congenitally also, or it can develop by the some accident or trauma also. There can be a limb length discrepancy, which means that one limb will be longer and the other limb will be shorter. So what you will do, you will be slightly laterally flexed on the shorter side, which means that your center of gravity will be shifted on the right side or the shorter side, because your more body proportion is there, you are laterally flexed on that side. So this is how structural deformities also, like scoliosis, kyphosis and limb length discrepancies, also alter the location of center of gravity. Coming to the last point, which is external force. Example, carrying a shoulder bag. If you are carrying a shoulder bag on a back side, that means you have a large amount of weight on your back. This means that your large weight is concentrated on the back side. What will that cause? It will cause the center of gravity to shift backward. Why? Because a lot of weight is on the back side. If you are carrying a bag on the front side, you are carrying a shoulder bag on the front side, which means that your more weight is located anteriorly and your center of gravity will be shifted anteriorly. So this is how all these factors help in deciding the location of center of gravity. I hope I have cleared how the location of center of gravity is decided by all these factors. Now let's see a case. If the mass is symmetrical, we all know that if the mass is symmetrical like circle, the point of that center of object is the center of mass. As you can see in this example also, this circle is the center of gravity. But if the object is asymmetrical like this stone, then what will happen? As in the limbs of the human body, the center of gravity will be nearer to the larger and heavier end. I have already told you that the center of gravity will be shifted in the direction which is large and heavier. In upright position, in an average body, we should be knowing that center of gravity is located at the second sacral vertebra. It is just anterior to the second sacral vertebra. As you can see in this diagram also, this is red point is depicting the center of gravity, which is just anterior to the second sacral vertebra, and center of gravity is not fixed. It changes during the movement. It changes according to the position change. So center of gravity is not fixed. In this example also, you can see this is the stone which is suspended by this rope, and this rope is actually tied at the center of mass. That is the reason this object is actually held symmetrically. This is happening because the rope is tied at the center of mass. Now there are some examples how center of gravity is changing in the positions. As you can see from the left to right direction, this is a man in which the center of mass is at the second sacral vertebra. Now he is running. So he is actually bending forward. His center of mass has been shifted anteriorly. Now he is leaning backward to kick an object or to practice a kick. Now more of weight is on the back side and it is slightly lower also. So more of the weight is at the backward side. This is an example of gymnastics. He is performing a movement with his hands, and in this movement center of gravity is lower over at this point, and he is standing, he is standing on his hand, and right now center of gravity is at this point. So all of this means that center of gravity is changed according to the position. If the position is changing, then the center of gravity will also change. Now this is Fosbury flop. In the Fosbury flop, this is the path of the center of gravity, how it travels along, and this is a NFL blocker, National Football League blocker, and he is blocking something. He needs stability, so this red point is depicting the center of gravity. Now center of gravity is clear. We are heading towards the line of gravity. What is the line of gravity? Line of gravity is, again, it is an imaginary vertical line from the center of gravity to the ground or surface the object or person is on. So this is a line, as you can see, this is a perpendicular line. This is a vertical perpendicular line to the surface, and it is passing from the center of gravity. There is one very important thing to tell about line of gravity. It is that, please listen very carefully, that the closer the line of gravity is to the center of or the base of support, the better a person is able to maintain the balance. If this line of gravity is closer to the base of support, we saw that base of support is the area on which you are standing. This is the area between your feet. So if a line of gravity is close to the base of support, you will be more in a balanced position. Moreover, you will be in a balanced position when this line of gravity will be closer to this base of support. We will understand by this thing by the examples also in coming slides. So I hope this is clear to you, that line of gravity is a vertical line. As you can see over here, this is a vertical line from the center of gravity to the ground or surface. Now let's understand this by examples also. This is the center of gravity of a runner who is taking his stance for the sprint. This is the starting stance for a sprint. It is also known as flying stance. So the person is leaning forward, and there is center of gravity, and this is the line of gravity. But why this sprinter is leaning forward and his center of gravity, as you can see, is shifted anteriorly? How this is helping the athlete? This is helping the athlete in acceleration. So when it comes to the movement, the athlete seeks to keep their line of gravity outside their base of support. They are taking their line of gravity outside. So as you can see, this is the base of support and this is the line of gravity. This is outside the base of support. This is not a very stable position. So what a person will do, he will try to achieve this stable position by propelling the body forward, by chasing this line of gravity. If in order to chase this line of gravity, the person will be able to make the acceleration. He will attain the acceleration and continued movement that is needed to generate the force. Why? Because right now the person is in unstable position and he wants to achieve a stable position. He wants to come in a stable position. So for coming that, he will accelerate faster. As with the sprinter who puts his line of gravity in front of his base of support in order to allow stability in the movement. So line of gravity is just in front of his base of support and he wants to attain stability. Now he need to accelerate faster in order to attain that stability. We will understand this by other examples also. So before that, let's talk something about the base of support. So I already told you that base of support is the area around outside edge of the sections of your body in contact with the ground. As you can see in this diagram also, between these two feet, this is the base of support and this is the base of support between these two feet. These points may be body parts or the extensions of the body parts also. If a player or if someone or injured person comes to you and he is walking with the help of crutches or any other walking aid, so इन दिस केस द एरिया दैट लाइज विद इन द क्रचेज दैट लाइज बिटवीन टू क्रचेज विल बी कॉल्ड एज द बेस ऑफ सपोर्ट बिकॉज यू आर टेकिंग द सपोर्ट फ्रॉम दिस ऑब्जेक्ट एंड दिस ऑब्जेक्ट विल हैव अ बेस That base will be your base of support. If you are walking freely without any assistance, without any assistive aid, then this base of support is your the area. It is the area between your two feet. But if you are taking any support, it is the area between the support that you are taking. The larger the base of support, the more the stable person is. Another very important thing to remember that if your base of support is more. Then you will be more stable. If I tell you that I am going to push you, you need to stable at that position and I am going to push you, then what will you do in the preparation? You will increase your base of support, you will increase your stance so that if I push you, you will be able to maintain the stability. If someone is standing on the single leg, which means the base of support is very less, it needs very little force to disturb the patient's balance. If someone is actually standing with the wide stance, it is hard to disturb the balance. Why? Because larger the base of support, larger will be the force needed to disrupt the balance. More will be the stability if the base of support is more. As you can see, this is the base of support of a person in the normal stance. He is walking. The base of support has increased. He is standing with the feet at a distant parts. Now the base of support has increased. So these are the two, three examples in which you can understand what is a base of support. There is one very interesting phenomena that if you widen your base of support, it will decrease your agility. Yes. So what is agility? First of all, as you can see, this is a rugby player and he is actually taking turns. She needs mobility in order to overcome all these defenders who are trying to take the ball. Widening your base of support also makes you less mobile because this is the position of stability. This is not the position of mobility. If you want to gain the mobility, you want to gain the acceleration, you need to reduce your base of support. First of all, because you are in a stable position and right now there is a defender in front of you and you want to change the direction so that he or she cannot catch you. So you need to change the direction. If you are in a stable position, if your base of support is more, first you will come into a less base of support, then you will change the direction. But if you are at the less base of support, then you can change the direction very quickly. That makes you agile, that makes your capability of changing the direction enhance, that enhances the capability of changing the direction to a specific stimulus. So you can change the directions rapidly in response to a stimulus. This is possible. Why this is possible? Because you are at a less stable position. It is easy for you to change the direction. But if your base of support is more, then it will take a lot of time to change the direction. That is why if a person's base of support is less, then he or she can quickly change the direction. As you can see in this diagram also, the player is having the lesser base of support. The base of support is only by the single limb. So it is easy for her to change the direction. So she can be very agile. She can be very agile in changing the direction. Now, what are the factors that affect the center of gravity and line of gravity? There are some specific factors also that affect the center of gravity. First is the age. What happens is, as the age is increased, the center of gravity becomes lower. First reason for that is when your age increases, your degenerative changes increases. What happens that your height also decreases. How your height is decreased? Because there is degenerative changes in the intervertebral disc also. There is forward flexion also. So these all factors combine your height and they results in decreasing you in the height. So if the height is decreased, the center of gravity becomes low. It is very interesting to know that in the newborn baby, a baby who's just born, the upper part of the body is heavier than the lower part. You can see that also. If you see a newborn baby, their upper part is always heavier than the lower part, which makes their center of gravity higher than the adults. So if a baby is newborn, as you can see this diagram also, he is having a higher center of gravity. As he advances, the center of gravity will be lessened. that will be heading towards the downward direction. So at the initial time of your life, your center of gravity is higher, but as the age advances, your center of gravity actually decreases in the height. So this is how the center of gravity and line of gravity changes with the age. In newborn baby, it is just above the umbilicus, and at 2 years, it is at the level of umbilicus, and at 5 years, it is below the level of umbilicus. And in adults, it is, as I already told you, that it is anterior to the second sacral vertebra. Now, second thing is gender. So these are all these factors that we are seeing. Is the age is also non-modifiable. You cannot decrease the advancements in your age. Then gender also. Center of gravity is different in male and it is different in female. Why? Because the muscular distribution is different. Male is having upper body which is heavier, so center of gravity has been shifted to the heavier direction. In females, their lower body is heavier as they have a wide pelvis, and more body fat and mass has been located on the downward side, so they have lower center of gravity. This I told you already in the previous slides. Now, addition of weight. How the addition of weight affects the center of gravity? If a person is carrying a backpack, the center of gravity will move backward. As a compensatory mechanism, the person will move his trunk forward to prevent falling. If a person carries weight in front of his body, the center of gravity will move forward. As a compensatory mechanism, the person will move his trunk backward. So, if I am carrying a backpack at the back, then what will happen? That my center of gravity is backward, so my anterior muscles has to work and bring the body forward. If I am carrying that backpack forward, now I am already shifting center of gravity forward. Now my back muscles have to act and bring that to the normal position. In both the cases, there are different muscles which are working. So there will be more problem in the back muscles if you are having the weight on the front side, and there will be more problem on the front side. Your muscles get fatigued easily if you are carrying the weight at the backpack. So you need to shift the position if you are carrying the weight for the longer durations. Subtraction of the weight. How the weight can be subtracted? If there is a case of amputation, there is a removal of a limb. So what will happen? The COG will move away from the amputated limb towards the healthy side. In case of an amputated left leg, the center of gravity will move upward and towards the right side because the weight on the left side is less. And we know that center of gravity will be shifted into the direction where the weight is more. When making an artificial limb, so remember, when the artificial limb is made, the weight of artificial limb should be equal to the weight of the healthy limb. This should be equal, because if there will be no proper distribution of weights, then this can actually cause the disruption in the center of gravity position, and that can lead to various problems. So this is how addition of weight and the subtraction of weight works in the case of center of gravity and line of gravity. What is the clinical implication of all these things that we have learned? So I have written an example for you. See, this mother is actually bending and trying to lift her child. So if we need to pick a child or the box, the knee should be bent and trunk flexed to move the COG down over the feet. So what she is doing is, she is bringing the center of gravity down, which means she is bringing the center of gravity closer to the base of support. And I told you earlier, the more the center of gravity or line of gravity close to the base of support, more will be the stability. So this is how she is coming into a stable position. Now she is able to lift the baby very accurately or correctly. Other example or the clinical implication is that in standing up from sitting, if I need to stand up from the sitting position, stability can be increased by moving the feet back. What I am doing is, I am moving my feet back and leaning the trunk forward in the preparation of the standing. What I am doing is, I am bringing my base of support close to this line of gravity. That is why I am able to attain a stable position and I can stand very easily. For that, I have to move my feet back to closer to the center of gravity, and then I have to lean forward so that my weight distribution is within the base of support, my center of gravity is within the base of support, and I can easily stand by doing that. So this is how we actually see the application of this center of gravity and line of gravity. These two topics are very basic, yet they are very important to understand because they actually form the foundation of learning the biomechanics. We are going to learn the biomechanics in few lectures. We are going to start the biomechanics of the shoulder joints also. So before that, I think there are some basic things that must be cleared in order to understand the regional biomechanics better. So this was all about today's lecture. If you have any query or doubt, you are always free to ask. You can drop your query or in the comment section, or you can mail us also. Thank you so much for listening patiently.